a couple of weeks ago, I decided to buy the shed a little treat. But when I say little, it barely fits on the bench here. So we best get it out of the box. So even out of the box, I'm struggling to get it all on the bench. But as you can see, this is an EPEver SHI400 pure sine wave inverter. And apart from a couple of pieces of packing foam and a certificate of quality control, this is everything you get in the box, a user manual and the device itself. And now we have the inverter out of the bag. We can see here on the left hand side, we've got the DC input, which is 10.8 to 16 volts. This is a 12 volt pure sine wave inverter, and I guess a cooling fan is in there. And on the right hand side, we have a universal socket here, which is protected with a gate. It doesn't need the earth as it would usually in the UK to be connected to move that gate, but at least there is something there. We can also see we've got three LED indicators here: the input level, that DC input, the load level, whether that's okay, or overload, and a fault light as well. The three dip switches here allow you to change the inverter from 230 to 220 volts, 60 to 50 hertz, and SAV stroke NOR. Now, I'm not entirely sure what that is. We'll have to look at the manual. An on-off switch, a remote on-off switch option as well here. And finally, an RS485 port, because this is compatible with number of the accessories in the EPEver solar charge controller range. So first things first, I want this to be European standard 230 volts. However, I think before we turn it on, we need to have a look inside, don't you? So I have removed the four screws and we can see the case is coming apart, but now I can see that this top aluminium extrusion here will come off. So actually, I only need to take the top screws off the other side. So now with six of the eight screws removed, the top removes. And the good thing is I can't see any floating components or anything awry in there straight away. On the left-hand side, the input side here, we can see this cable. How thick is that? So unfortunately we can't see the markings on the cable here, but this is 16 millimeter squared and it's slightly shy of that, I would suggest, but still a hefty piece of cable. The positive goes straight into the main board here where there are two 30 amp fuses. I'm guessing they will be in parallel to give 60 amps total. And we can see the large transformers here in the middle, and at the bottom some MOSFETs, I'm guessing, which are bolted onto the side of the case, as is this small heatsink here. And there's some more MOSFETs there at the top. There's a daughter board down here, which presumably is all the control software. There's some sort of microcontroller, it looks like, under there. There's also a buzzer, presumably to announce a low voltage. And then finally, we've got the little breakout board here for the LEDs and the RS485 port. The mains obviously out. And then is this here a little thermistor attaching here to the heatsink and those MOSFETs for over temperature protection? The capacitors down here are all rated for 25 volts, and this large one here is actually a 500 volt capacitor. So all in all, so far, I'm quite impressed with the build quality of this unit. So before using the inverter, you need to read and save the safety instructions. So I will read most of them. This manual covers three different models: the 400, which I've got, the 600 and 1000 watt inverter. It claims a wide DC input voltage, low harmonic distortion. There's an energy saving mode, LED indicators, and the output voltage and frequency can be changed. It's got extensive protection, short circuit, overload, under and over input voltage, over temperature, and inverters in a fault identification protections. And it can continually operate at full power, which is good to know. So the 12 volt version will work well. 10.5 volts to 16 volts is what it said, and that LED will change colour. Green is good. Load level, again, orange is a low load, green is a normal load, red is a large load, and blinking is overload. There's a fault status LED as well that does various different things, and the buzzer sounds for various different reasons. Now, although I've bought the 400 watt version, it will actually do more than 400 watts. Look, it'll do 200% output, 800 watts, for 1.5 seconds. So if you've got a load which takes a large draw to start it up, something like a motor, then this will provide up to 800 watts for 1.5 seconds. And then you better make sure that that motor draws less than 400 watts after that 1.5 seconds. And this is the bit I need here for that last dip switch, the mode switch or the saving mode. When the switch is on the saving side, the SAV side, the inverter will enter a saving mode. It will shut off the output if the load is less than 20 VA. So I need to turn that off, I think, for my initial testing. And finally, I think this little circuit here explains the external switching of the inverter. And I am going to install a new DC breaker here. This is a 63 amp 125 volt DC breaker here. And the reason I've gone for a 60 amp one is because if this goes over current a little bit for a while, well, 600 watts, for example, divided by 12 volts, well, very roughly, that's about 60 amps, isn't it? And this can, of course, go up to 800, so I needed something a bit beefier. So I've had to turn the inverter around here to connect up, and these wires aren't live at the moment. 16 millimeter squared cable going in here, that should be man enough. And positive and negative, and I think 16 millimeters is about as wide as we can get into these terminals. Okay, so I've connected up the cables. Let's turn on the DC breaker and turn on the main switch. There was a beep there and the fan spun for half a second, and now we've got three green lights on the front. Well, that seems to be working. Let's plug in a meter. Now I'm expecting there'll be a few of these funky angles in this particular video, but there we are, 229 volts, and that's running at 49.9 hertz. That's pretty good. And it's worth just looking at the no load current, so I'll just zero my meter, clamp it around there. 657 milliamps. And we'll just put a small load on here. I've got a 40 watt incandescent lamp on. And if we turn that on, it's remaining at the same voltage there. So we're pulling just 0.4 of an amp. 42 watts for my lamp there. And well, the frequency of that signal is holding up nicely too. And the last thing I want to do is compare the EPEver SHI400 pure sine wave inverter with my old modified sine wave inverter. So with the oscilloscope plugged in, let's turn on the modified sine wave inverter. Apologies for the noise in the background, but look at that square wave there. That's not what I'm hoping to see on the EPEver. So there we have it, the EPEver pure sine wave inverter does seem to be a pure sine wave, but my goodness, is it making my oscilloscope go a bit crazy. So there we have the EPEver SHI400 pure sine wave inverter. And I mentioned earlier that it works with a number of the EPEver solar charge controllers accessories. And it does. It works with the official RS485 to USB cable. It also works with the Ebox Wi-Fi 01, and there's no reason why it shouldn't work with my homemade USB cable. But perhaps we'll save that for another video. The unit seems to be well made. It is creating a pure sine wave. The 600 milliamp no load current I think is pretty reasonable. And the fact that this will do short bursts up to 800 watts is very useful. On reviewing the video, it seems this inverter is quite noisy, not on the sine wave output itself, but some of this electronics in here is making an awful lot of noise. It was picked up on my microphone, and also it was clearly causing my oscilloscope a few issues. Hopefully that's not going to cause me too many problems. I'll leave a link for this item down below. It only seems to be sold on eBay by one seller at the moment, but they are open to best offers. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. If you have, give me a thumbs up, subscribe down below, comment if you can, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.